Borneo rainforest is the oldest in the world, 130 million years old. That's 70 million years older than the Amazon. Mount Kinabalu, the dominant feature in the Kinabalu Park, is the highest peak between the Himalayas and New Guinea. The Kinabalu Park is a World Heritage Site and has a total area of 75,370 hectares. By comparison, Singapore has a land area of about 64,000 hectares. Out of the 12 regions of mega biodiversity in the world, Borneo ranks with Amazonia and equatorial Africa. Borneo lies in the heart of the mega biodiversity ecoregion of the Indo-Pacific Basin and Malaysia. Sabah is special because in terms of biodiversity per unit area, Sabah is the best in Borneo. According to the National Geographic, 10 square kilometers of Malaysian rainforest has more flora and fauna than that of North America and Europe combined. Here, in the Indo-Pacific global center of coral biodiversity, is the cradle of coral evolution. Beginning with 70 genera in the areas around Borneo, it reduces gradually as one moves outwards. The coral triangle, the Amazon of the seas, is the center of marine biodiversity for the world. It is home to one of the most diverse collections of marine life in the world, with over 75% of coral species known to science. Over 3,000 species of reef fish, over 500 species of coral. This is unmatched in the world in terms of marine biodiversity per unit area. The Borneo pygmy is the world's smallest elephant. Herds of 30 or more roam the jungles and riverbanks in the east coast. The Sukau area in the lower reaches of the Kinabatangan River has one of the world's richest diversity of flora and fauna, including the proboscis monkey, one of the 10 species of primates found in Sabah. The snake bird, or oriental darter, which has disappeared from peninsular Malaysia, is seen here in large numbers. The east coast is also home to the globally recognized orangutan. The Sepilok Orangutan Rehabilitation Center was established in 1964, making it the first of its kind in the world. The Gomantong Cave, famous for its populations of swiftlets, which produce valuable edible nests, is protected by strict laws to ensure sustainability. Other conservation areas include the Danum Valley Conservation Area, Tubin Wildlife Reserve, and Maliau Basin, the Lost World. The Danum Valley Field Center is both a research and education facility.
I am very impressed. I think Sabah is one of the prime ecotourism destinations of the world. And since the first time, I've been impressed by the beauty of the natural landscape, first and foremost. So Borneo in general, and very specially Sabah, I insist, is a prime ecotourism destination for ecotourists around the world.
Jungle lodges in selected areas promise visitors the rare and unique experience of being in the world's oldest rainforest. Beyond the shores of mainland Sabah, conservation areas include the Tunku Abdul Rahman Park, which was established in 1974, following a joint study by the government and WWF Malaysia. Pulau Salingan, where giant turtles come ashore to lay their eggs, is open to visitors, but they must observe strict rules enforced by the Sabah Parks rangers. Several other areas have been identified for marine conservation purposes, including the Tun Sakaran Marine Park off the east coast and the Tun Mustafa Marine Park in the north. World-renowned Sipadan Island has also been placed under strict control, while other islands frequented by visitors are closely monitored. Mm-hmm. Borneo is the orchid island of the world, containing more than 10% of the orchids of the world. More than half of these are found in the Kinabalu Park. Other wonderful plants of Sabah include the Nepenthes, or pitcher plant, and the world's largest flower, the Rafflesia. Not surprisingly, the Kinabalu Park is a center of plant diversity for Southeast Asia. A comprehensive botanical collection exists at the Sabah Agricultural Park, located within the Crocker Range, which is Malaysia's biggest mountain range. Closer to the city of Kota Kinabalu is another treasure trove, the Lok Kawi Wildlife Park. Within the city itself is the Likas Wetland, a mangrove reserve visited by hundreds of migratory birds each year. And on that note, Sabah offers something very special for bird watchers. There are more than 622 species of birds in Borneo, and out of this number, 34 species are endemic to Sabah. There are 8 species of hornbills in Borneo, and all can be found in Sabah.